Hi everybody, I've got a great craft idea. I went and got my greens and flattened them overnight. Scissors, paintbrush, utility knife. You have to have some wax paper. I shaped some crayons with my crayon sharpener. And I had dental crayons. And my iron. Let's start with just opening up this box of crayons. And I will match the box of crayons with the shavings I've already got. Already gotten the wrapper off. That looks like orange. That's orange too. Kind of a turquoise blue. I don't know. I'll have to check and recheck here. Let's just make sure we get the right matching colors here and put the rest aside for a little bit. So our first step is just to go ahead and take all of the wrappers off of your crayons. Depending on how many stained glass frame artwork that you want to make, you may use the whole crayon, it just depends. I am making 4 different works of art with my melted crayons. So I used about a whole crayon and a half or a third. Probably safer ways to do this, but I opt for the quickest, easiest way. One must be very careful using a utility knife. Anytime that you use a knife, it is still kind of risky. But definitely quicker. You can see how easy those are peeling off. That one was already coming off. That's nice when that happens. See, I have the wrong orange. That doesn't seem the same as that one, so I'm gonna put that one away. The other one's too pumpkin-y. This seems like the right one. But do I read labels? Sometimes. Okay, that one didn't want to come off very easily, did it? Some of these crayons have a bit of a film on the outside. You can see that. Don't eat that anymore. Let me just show you. If you get a very nice sharpener, you can shave into the bottom of that and just have them land in there and then spill it out into your cup. But I'm not going to use it. I am going to just go ahead and shave right into the little muffin cup I have these shavings in already. Now this brush is just to get all those flakes out of your sharpener so that you can be sure not to mix other colors in once you start a new color. eventually you may put a mix colors, but you mix it on the page. You want to keep them separate until or unless you decide how you want your colors mixed. And I'm doing okay with that, but I still tend to get a little bit mixed up with others. So, this brush will come in handy a little later too. We'll see what I need it for. I think we need a little more yellow. And that's mainly because I just love yellow. And it mixes so well with other colors. So, I like it. Get that out of there. Alrighty. Let's just call that good enough for now. I didn't use all of them yet, but I just didn't want to spend so much time on that. I just wanted to show you how and what I did. Okay. If I need any more, they'll be right there. And that works good. Plus, they're pretty to look at. Alright then. Next. Let's clear off our spot a little bit here. And don't forget to, when you get your greens, make sure you flatten them the best you can for days or just overnight, whatever it takes to get them flat enough to stay in between the wax paper once it is ironed. So you can, there's a lot of things you can use that would make a shadow or a silhouette like these plants would. It doesn't have to be just plants. You could use flattened flower petals or whatever, stickers. But I chose these greens because they were in my yard. I try my best to just use things I've already got around the house rather than spending more money. So let's neaten up our work area here and get ready to create. Let's put the first green down. Move you guys over here. Pink for maybe the feeling of spring. These are green after all. Now I'm not putting much wax on the leaves themselves. I'm trying to avoid that a little bit because you want the wax to melt onto the wax paper. The crayon is going to create the mood. It's already starting to look a little pretty colorful even before we melt it. But I'm very curious to see how this is going to turn. Alright, so you put your other piece of wax paper on top. Carefully. Then you find a... You can use a towel or... I chose this kind of... paper, kind of towel, paper towel, so that the heat from the iron would come through very easily, because we need to melt the wax and the wax paper together. My surface that I'm working on is a nice thick towel covered with butcher paper, or wrapping paper actually, butchering paper or wrapping paper, butcher paper or wrapping paper would work, either one. But you're basically protecting your work surface from wax and heat. Now I have my iron set on medium high. And that is because I'm impatient. Okay. Look how much wax melted and how much actually got onto the paper underneath. Look at that. This is why you want to protect your surface. But see that cool and hardens so it does not interfere with your next project. It does not bleed through, so do not worry about leaving the markings from the previous project. Unless, of course, it bothers you that you cannot possibly what your next project is projected to look like. I don't have any issues. I can see it. And I can project in my mind what it's going to look like. So, we are using two different kinds of blue. And the turquoise. And I'm going to add yellow so we can keep in the theme of the colors. I don't want any psychedelic stuff yet. That'll come later. Blue and another blue and yellow will all go with the green very nicely. In my opinion. So I'm still using the same cloth because the wax did not come off onto the surface of this cloth for some reason. It did not absorb, and I don't have any glue for it. I can see any specks of color that is making it onto the cloth, but it's not bleeding through or anything like that. So, let's check it out and see how that came out. Iron on low, and I couldn't get the wax to melt on low. So, like I said, I'm impatient, so I put on high. You want all your wax paper to melt together so it will stay together and hold everything in. I like those colors together very, very. I'm just moving them around so you can see it and also hear it. I just like the sound of wax paper. Wax paper doesn't need sound. Okay. is my last leaf. This time I think I'll do a bit of rainbow colors because I can't resist. I am such a rainbow person. But then I'll get in a mood and just want two colors. You know, I do the same thing with Christmas lights. Sometimes just green and blue, sometimes just red, yellow, and orange. And sometimes all of them. But I'm very particular about the two colors that go together. Oops, yeah, I mixed it up. Got some red in my green. This should be interesting. I also want to mention to you that if you don't have a crayon sharpener, you may use a cheese grater, and that will give you smaller flakes, smaller shavings. That's okay. It just all depends on what you want. To reiterate that you really need to protect your surface, whatever you're working on. You could use an ironing board, but you would still have to protect that surface as well. You do not want any wax getting onto your good furniture or your good towels or your good ironing board, whatever. The towel that I have under here is not one of my best towels, just in case. So that's what I would recommend as well. Whatever protective surface you put on should be something that you're not that concerned about. Oh wow, look at those rich colors. I think I'm gonna have to go over this one again. I may go over all of them again, actually. But let's just do this one again real quick. I can see some pieces that I just didn't get to. Yeah, I read somewhere that you put your iron on low, and I thought, nothing's happening. This is going to take on a whole different look when you have it up against your window, because that's where these will end up. I see more that I didn't melt. I guess I'll go over this again a little bit later. Okay, last project here. Now I get to just use the rest of my shavings, so I'm going to brush the rest of the shavings out of my cup. They're kind of sticking in there and couldn't get it out, so that is the another reason why I wanted a device to help me with these crayon shavings. Because oddly, crayon shavings get slightly sticky or magnetic or something. I'm not sure what's going on, but they seem to want to adhere to the surfaces of everything that they get stuck on. I don't know why. Okay, that's enough of that. This is gonna be wild. Can't wait to see what this one's going to do. all these colors go together so well. How can I resist? Let's make it a tree or a bush or something. Actually, this is looking a little bit like I'm making a peace sign or a chicken foot. It'll be what it'll be. Spread those out a little bit. Couldn't resist. It'll blend. We'll see what it does. Even that out a little bit. If you're not careful, you put too much colors all together. It can actually turn brown, so we'll see if this survives and doesn't turn brown. Alright, a little bit purple here. Let's see how this goes. Purple or maroon? Oh, this is purple. I'm not gonna use all those because there's a lot. Up. A lot of wet. We'll see how it fares. To what? How will it turn out? There's no plant in it, so it should be interesting. Oh boy. Did you got to make sure that you go over every last square inch? Put all that wax paper and the edges to stick together. Pushing the wax in any certain direction. That's just theory. Whoa, it survived. Oops, I got some stuff. Didn't quite make it. It's not all the way. Well, I just got through ironing all the rest of them one more time. I like that. Let me think. Wouldn't that be pretty? So sprinkly. Frame them. I am just measuring. I have two pieces of construction paper here. Or three. It depends on how many pictures you have to frame. But I'm going to cut all of it at once, and I'm only going to put measurements on the top page. And I just go 1.5 inches per strip. Measure on the top, measure on the bottom, 1.5 inches. That's my guide to go ahead and make a line up and down. That should be fairly straight. Then I am going to lines after I'm done with that. And then I'll show you what's next. I've had a towel out here this whole time, and it's not for anything that I need it for. In the project, you don't need a towel. Actually covering up something unsightly on my table. Just letting you know. It's getting real. Okay, strip number one. Thing about doing it this way with scissors and just holding it in your hand is you have to hold tight. Separating. Unfortunately, this project does not demand perfection. But you can see I already had to move it over once, and these strips are not going to be perfect. But they're pretty close. Close enough for what I want to do, and you'll see what I want to do. See what I mean? It's going off crooked already. Sometimes it's too late to correct. Keep going off at an angle. Well, that's close enough. Don't need the ruler anymore. I need some glue. Here, and I'll just line this up on that side, line that up on that side. I'm not gonna get fancy, I'm just gonna do it sort of like an old country window. I'm using my PVA glue again because it really dries fast on paper. If you saw my Christmas craft video, you'll have seen that I used this glue on that because you want stuff to dry fast. It's a good thing I have my towel out here after all, so I can wipe this glue off my fingers. I'm a mess. Now, this isn't scientific. I am just going to eyeball this and try to line it up the best I can, the width of my wax paper, and make it even on the other side the best I can. Okay, it's fairly straight. another square. And you ready? Let's put another across the top. Just line it up best I can. Square with the edges. And it should just line up pretty good. There we go. No worries about that glue, it'll dry clear. Alright, so I just want to center that best I can. And tape it down. Make it adhere to the spot that you want. And in this case, I'm lining it up with the wax paper edge on the left side. Because it just happens to work. That way I don't have to cut on that. Little bit more tape. If you want to, of course, you may staple that if you're more comfortable with that. I don't know. I just use tape, and I don't think that the glue would work with that. I'm just theorizing. I don't know if you think that glue would work to hold construction paper to wax paper, then by all means do try it. Okay, so let's just trim our edges. There now. I really like that. What do you think? Okay. Set that aside and get the next one. Okay. Same thing on this one. As we did on the other one. I really like this pink one. I really like it. I'm having a hard time deciding which one I like best, I think. Got these crazy silver glitter nails on right now. It's not showing up very well in the video, but it's silver glitter. Just get really wild sometimes. Okay, now let's see, I feel like it's important to match up those corners. Because that sets the precedent of your angles from there on out. That'll keep you square. So long as you cut your pieces square in the first place. See? It's not perfect, but it's pretty good. No, I didn't tape it first this time. Kind of stand still. Let's go ahead and tape it now so I can be sure that it's gonna hold for the rest of what I need to do. The thing is too, I am how many times I've said this in a video, but I am not a perfectionist. And will notice that I do cover up a bit of green and just like to play and do things the way I like them. Nothing's perfect. I have to tell you that I have fought during this video so far. I have fought every kind of noise and frustration. But I'm just like, I am gonna get this thing done, and I'm not gonna let you neighbors and sounds defeat me. I'm going to get this done. I'm actually doing this project on a table that I have never used before. One that actually has rollers. And I rolled it out of my bedroom and into this back room just to escape the relentless sounds outside. It's just been a crazy day. This is just gorgeous. I suppose you could be very, very careful about cutting and measuring your wax paper as well, but I was not. If you were, then you would have really nice clean edges and you wouldn't have to cut as much as I am. I was just like, okay, here's the first piece. Here's the next piece. I rarely measure anything, not even in my recipes for food. But these strips I had to be just a bit more careful with. Because I did want a semi-straight frame. It won't be exactly straight at all. Not at all. But close. Close. Okay. There we go. In spite of all the challenge to make this video, I am just enjoying the heck out of it. I so love the results. I'm really glad that I went out and got those leaves from the plants in my front yard. I put it in between the pages of a book. If you're worried about staining your book, you could use the wax paper or some other kind of paper in between your plant and the pages. And then I put super heavy books on top of the other book that was holding my green plant. So even though the plants are not dried out, not by any means, they are at least mostly. And then, of course, ironing helps to flatten it out some. But you don't want to leave the iron on your wax paper project for very long, or you could burn things. You can burn everything. You could probably even burn your house down if you left the iron there. What a thought. Oh my goodness. Burn your house down. Okay. This one's proving a little bit more difficult because I didn't do any straight edges on the wax paper. Like that just fine. Okay, where's all four projects? I love them. I'm gonna get them up on the window to show you what they look like with glass and sunshine. I like them. Okay, here they are. We actually have snow outside right now, so it's making it very bright. But this will make me feel like spring, even though we still have snow. Good luck doing this project if you want to do it, and thank you so much for joining me here today. So wonderful to have you. See you in the next video.